In this video, we're going to talk about setting up a new customer in QuickBooks. So the first thing you want to do is you want to click on the Customer Center up here. It's also up under Customer Center. Once you're in, you can click on New Customer and Job. Say New Customer. Okay. You put in the new customer's name, Joe's Shack. You can use this opening balance field, but I wouldn't suggest using it. I would suggest putting the actual transactions in QuickBooks. I actually wish they didn't give you this as an option. But you can if you want to. It will just create a journal entry, or it'll create an entry that will put the balance towards opening balance equity. And sometimes that can mess up your equity. So I'd rather see the actual invoice go in there, but it's an option for a quick starting balance. Again, the company name, I'm just going to copy this down. These are all fields that if you want to use them, you can. They're all searchable fields, and they're also fields that you can pull to put on an invoice or on a template if you have a template when you're going to send out some information to customers. All right, so I'm going to say Joe Smith. Joe Smith is the contact. If I have a different contact, I can change that. Phone number, fax number. Okay, alternate phone number, alternate contact, email address. If you want to blind CC, or if you want to CC, carbon copy anyone on anything that you send to him. They have their bill to address here, so Joe's Shack, attention Joe Smith, do I want to say that? No, I just want to say Joe's Shack, 123 16th Street, Joe's, Joe Town, LA, 78456. Now, a lot of people have asked me, you can put a phone number in this bill to box too. It's not necessarily the best place to put it. You know, you have your phone number up here, but you can put it down there if you want to. If you have the ship to information, if you're shipping things to them, you can copy this across. You can also add new ship to addresses. You can have a whole bunch of ship to addresses in there. All right, under additional information here, what type of customer is this? This is a retail customer. What is the customer's terms? We are going to go ahead and say net 15 for Joe. He's gotten approved for net 15 terms. Who's their rep? All right, let's go ahead and add a new sales rep here. We're going to say the rep is Jamie James. All right. Asking me this information. So Jamie James is an employee of ours. The initials are JJ. Okay. So that means that anytime we create an invoice for Joe's Shack, JJ is going to show up in the rep field as a default. And then their preferred send method. I always suggest filling this in, especially in the newer versions of QuickBooks where you can do the mass emailing when you're doing your accounts receivable checking on people to get them to pay you. Always suggest filling this in, and email, of course, is the easiest way to get the information out the door quickly. What is your customer's sales tax information? Are they taxable or non-taxable? And what is their sales tax rate? And if they're non-taxable, what is their resale number? You can keep that right in here. If they have a certain price level, and then you can also have custom fields, which you will talk about in the custom fields on customers demo. Next, you go to the payment information. What is their account number? 14879. What is their credit limit? This is a great thing to set on new customers just so that they don't run away with too much inventory before paying things down. What is their preferred payment method? Cash, check, credit card, MasterCard, Visa. So you can go ahead and enter their credit card number to keep it on file. So let's say that the first five purchases they have to buy on credit card, you can save it here on file. And it will save it. It will protect you. It is PCI compliant, and you'll have to, it'll show you only the last four digits of the credit card number. Okay, then you have the job information. If this is for a job, you can put in the status, the start, projected end, and the actual end date, all fields that you can search by, the job description, and job type. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and say okay, and I've created my new customer.